Well, the most important thing is A, turn all the power off. So we need to get the power to the furnace and the power to the MicroPower Guard turned off while you take it out. And then getting the media inserted properly. There's a little electrode that powers the media of the MicroPower Guard. And you need to get that installed properly or it's just not going to work right.
What we're going to do today is we're going to change the media in our MicroPower Guard high efficiency air cleaner. And there are a few simple things that you always want to be aware of that you really need to do. And one is you really want to shut down the system when you do this. Now, you really can't hear it right now. But my blower is running right now. I can hear it slowly running. And so we really aren't going to want to pull the filter out while it's running. And so we're going to take a couple of safeguards so that doesn't happen. But typically, our MicroPower Guard is down here in the return area in this filter slot here. And typically, the blower's running right now. I don't know if you can hear it or not, but I just want to pull it out. There's a little red indicator light on here. So when that is on, you know you have power to it. And whenever it's out, pulled out just like this, you just literally unplug this power cord like that. And just let it lay. Now, I'm going to go ahead and turn the power off to the furnace. I'm going to shut everything down by simply unplugging my furnace. Now, you'll either have a typical electrical plug like this, or for a number of years, we put a light switch. It looks just like a light switch that you would toggle it off. So now it's dead quiet now, and nothing is operating. Now, we're not only going to show you how to change the media on this filter, but kind of explain a little bit about how does a MicroPower Guard work. And these things are absolutely phenomenal for taking particles out of the air. Now, I was looking here. I replaced this media about 2 months ago. Okay, so this is a two-month-old media, and this is a aluminum frame that is hinged. And it's going to open up in the middle here. So we're just going to pop it open here. I'm just going to lay it out as if I were at somebody's home. So this is 2 months. Now, what's really cool about this is, though this material looks like a conventional furnace filter, it really is not. And let me show you how it's different. For one, a regular furnace filter is going to be a one-inch frame filter like this. And it's going to have a material very similar to this. But when it filters, it actually loads the surface, the face of the filter. You've probably seen it if you've replaced your own filter. You'll see it almost kind of caked on, but it really builds up on the very surface of it. Now, this is the media that we are replacing right here. And it is it's sandwiched. It actually has three layers to it. So we're going to slowly pull it out. There's an electrode right here that we'll show. We'll be more aware of that when we go to put the new one in. But I want to show you, I'm going to just step over it here. Here is a brand new one, so you can see what a brand new one looked like 2 months ago. And what you're going to see here, what's really interesting is, do you see how you really don't see that loading on the surface like you do a regular air filter? But look at it. It has these fiberglass fibers, and it's sandwiched together. I'm going to pull it apart here. It's sandwiched together, two layers of it, and then it has these carbon electrodes running through it. And what we do here is let me just go ahead and load up a new one. Now, I have a vacuum here to clean this frame. It's really in very good shape. I just did it. So if it's been in longer, sometimes I will just take a vacuum cleaner and just vacuum off the screen and things like that. But here's that same media. You can certainly see I'll put the dirty one behind us now. In the clean one, you can see those electrodes. See that charcoal band right here? What we do is we use that charcoal band to put an electrical charge on this entire filter. And so this is the one tricky part of replacing this filter is this electrode wants to come in contact with this carbon, and it's got a little prong sticking straight up. So watch how I do this. I'm going to just pull the first layer underneath the probe. You see that? And then the top layer lays right on it, right there. Right there is that probe. And see, there's going to be a little dimple here on the filter itself that's going to back that up. So we just kind of square it up. It really, sometimes the filter sticks out just a little bit. That's perfectly fine. What we're going to do is we're going to just close this clip. And it's ready to go back in. That is really all there is to it. We're going to take it and we're going to plug it back in and slide it back in. But let's take a closer look at this media. This is really cool. Like I was saying before, can you see how it's not really loaded on the surface? But can you see if when we open this up, all of the white fibers have turned gray? You see that? Even if I open up the middle of one of those layers, all the way through it, they are turning gray. Now, what's happening here is air is going through this media, and all these fibers, here's one fiber. I can pull it out here. You won't be able to see it, but I'm holding a fiber. It's like a hair. That hair is going to have an electrical charge on it. And these particles are so small, as they pass through, they collect on those fibers, just like a magnet picks up metal filings. The really cool thing is once that particle attaches to that fiber, now the particle is magnetized, and there's going to be another particle that's going to come along and stick onto it. And so that's why all the dust, rather than just loading on the surface, it is actually being caught all the way through this filter. So there's our dirty one. We're going to take that to the trash. The new filter, we're going to simply slide back in. And if you ever are curious or forget, you know, literally just put it back the same way you took it out. But a lot of times folks question which way should the airflow go through. Know that airflow is always going towards the furnace. So your system might have the return air on the other side or on the back side or whatever, but know that the air movement is going towards the furnace. So what I'm doing here, I'm simply going to plug it in. Now that light is not coming back on right now because I've got the power turned off to the furnace here. So let me put my 1 hour magnetic cover over it. I'll put the bottom half on here first, and then we'll want to make sure the light comes on. So I'm now going to plug this back in, put the power back to the furnace. And I can look in here and see that my little red light is on. So I know I've got power to it. And it's slowly, everything is slowly staging back up. This is a little magnetic cover that works really well. For sealing that up, it makes it really easy to take the filter out, but yet it seals it up so we don't leak any air around it. And that's all there is to it. We've now put the fresh media filter in it, and what is really cool, by putting the new media that's got the new charcoal filter and everything, it is a brand new filter.
Okay, thanks for the demo, Dad.
Very good.
All right, talk to you later.
Okay, bye.
Bye.